Hello friends, today we are going to discuss on topic principles of serving. Myself Bipin Patil, assistant professor, department of civil engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So my dear friends, these are the learning outcomes for today's session. So at the end of this particular session, student will be able to, first one, explain serving, means what do you mean by serving, types of serving, basic types, and principles of serving. So throughout this particular session, we'll discuss regarding serving, the types and principles. First one, what do you mean by serving? What is serving? My dear friends, serving is the art of measuring, first one, distances, angles and positions. It may be above the ground level, it may be below the ground level, on or near the surface of earth. In short, surveying is the art of measuring the distances, angles and positions on or near the surface of the earth. So for that we require different instruments. So first one, dumpy level is there, atto level is there, then tilting level is present, theodolite is present, total station, such a list of instruments are present to carry out this particular surveying work. Uses of surveying. Why surveying is essential? So few points I already listed here. One by one we'll discuss. First one, surveying is essential to measure the areas. Suppose land is present, to measure the areas of this particular lands, we required surveying. Building is present, to identify the area of this particular building, surveying is essential. Second point, to prepare a different types of maps. So in that particular maps, we just consider topographical condition of earth, topographical map we require, and this map you have to prepare by using surveying. Cadastral map is there, engineering map is also present. Engineering maps, to identify the boundary conditions, area, periphery of your building, land area is there. Military map, to prepare a small plan regarding any type of work, we required surveying work. So for that we are using military map. In military work also it is essential. Contour map, basically two types of contouring are favorite, or we say very essential. Block contouring work, radial contouring work. So for that we required surveying work. And last one that is very important, geological map. To prepare a geological condition of a earth surface, we required surveying work. Then next one, different building works, different government projects, we required surveying work. It is very useful for the purpose of designing the projects. So which types of projects are present? First one, dam is there, construction of a dam, construction of a canal, construction of a weir, construction of a roads, railways, airports, surveying is essential. Primary survey, preliminary survey work, and after that, this particular project you have to finish it. So for that we required surveying work. Next one, it is used to making of a plans in connection with legal documents. So first, you just study the area, study the maps, and after that you have to prepare a plan. And these particular plans you are using for government work. Then last one, if any disputes are present in a property by two parties or third one party, so these particular disputes you can easily solve by using surveying. So certain plans may be used as a legal documents to rectify these particular disputes regarding properties, and this particular surveying plays most important role during these particular cases. Next one, these are nothing but the types of serving. First one, plain serving. Second one, geodetic serving. So few points already mentioned. A surface is considered plane in x and y dimension, x and y direction. So we call that as plane serving. And same thing, if the earth surface is considered spherical in revolution, so for example, ellipsoid is there, so we call that geodetic serving is there. Z, that is third dimension, height, a reference to the mass spherical surface of the earth from mean sea level. And third dimension, this height is referred similarly from mean sea level, but from the surface of earth. Last one, corrections applied to the curvature is for long strips, that is nothing but for highway work. And here very precise survey work, boundary conditions and coastal networks are present. So in such cases we are using geodetic surveying is there. Less area is available for plane survey, more area is present, so 2-3 hectares, so we are using geodetic surveying work. Next one, these are nothing but the principles of surveying. Basically two principles are present. First one, to work from the whole to the part. And second one, to locate a new station point by at least two measurements. It may be your linear, it may be angular, from fixed reference points. Let's we discuss first principle, to work from whole to the part. Refer this particular figure. Land area is present. Your first task is irregular shape land is present. So you just first fix your control points. That is nothing but you just observe the whole area is first enclosed by main station. That is nothing but A, B, C, D and so on. And these station points you just join by using one line. The line we called as main survey lines. Sometimes we called as controlling station and controlling lines are there. Further, the area is divided into number of parts by forming a well-conditioned triangles. Now you just observe A, B. So the control lines are over main survey lines. These lines, these are nothing but you just bifurcate the whole area into number of triangles. Now you just observe, if I join BF line, so one triangle is present, second, third, fourth, just like number of triangles are present. Now the main survey lines are measured very accurately by using standard chain, engineering chain, metric chain, Gunter chain or tapes. Then the sides of triangles are measured, A to B, B to C, C to D. So A to B so and so distance is present, B to C the distance is so and so. So at last, okay, periphery of this particular control stations, you just measured it and then you just move towards your the remaining parts. That is nothing but the triangles, sides of this particular triangles. So whatever the errors are present, A to B, small error is there, B to C, very small error is there. So when we are identifying the area from work from the whole to the part, so the less areas are present in your this particular picture. Similarly, to work from the whole to the part, first few errors are present in that. How to overcome this? It prevents accumulation of our errors. If there is any error in the measurement of any side of a triangle, then it will not affect the whole work and the error can always be detected and eliminated. Suppose instead of that, if I started from to work from part to the whole, so whatever the errors are present in this particular part, same errors are carry forward in next line. So at last, tremendous error is present. To avoid that, we are moving to work from whole to the part, not to work from part to the whole. Similarly, whatever the changes are present when we start our work to work from the part to the whole, if the reverse process from part to the whole is followed, then the minor errors in a measurement will be magnified in the process of expansion. And these errors will become absolutely uncontrollable. Means see, A to B, 0.1 meter error is there. So B to C, 0.2 meter. C to D, double, 0.4 meter is there. D to E, 0.8 meter. These errors are cumulatively increases. And because of that, at last, the outputs are very worst. So to avoid that, we are using to work from whole to the part, not part to the whole. Second principle is present to locate new station by at least two measurements, linear or angular, from fixed reference point. So AB is fixed one. Linear measurement, C point we are going to establish here. So A to B is fixed one. A to C, you just prepare one arc or fix the dimension. B to C by using linear measurement. Suppose this distance is 10 meter, 10 meter. So from A to C, 10 meter, you prepare one arc. B to C, 10 meter, you prepare one arc and establish new station point. Second one, one angular measurement and one linear measurement. AB is fixed. Angular measurement, so and so this particular angle is present, 75 degrees there. So from 75 degree, you prepare one line. And from B to C, this is nothing but your new established point. So here you just prepare the distance, linear measurement. Prepare this 10 meter distance and mark it here and establish third point. Similarly, A to B, two angular measurement, theta, theta, theta 1, theta 1. So 45 degree, 45 degree. Cross section, intersection point, it produce you the new established point. So the cross mark, interpolation between these two particular points, easily you can identify third. So the new station should always be fixed by at least two measurement from fixed reference points. Linear measurement refers to horizontal distance measured by either chain or tape. And angular measurement is carried out by using prismatic compass or theodolite. So easily you can establish third one point, either angular or linear measurement. So my dear friends, now you just try to pause the video and try to give the answer of this particular question. This is the answer of this particular question. To prepare this particular video, I refer, these are the references for my video. Thank you.